representative of the family in grief, in a country in mourning, before a world in shock. We're all united, not only in our desire to pay our respects to Diana, but rather in our need to do so. Because such was an extraordinary appeal that tens and millions of people are taking part in the service all over the world. It's a more remarkable tribute to Diana than I can ever hope to offer to her today. Diana was the very essence of compassion, of duty, of style, of humanity, and of beauty. All over the world, she was the symbol of selfless humanity, a standard bearer for the rights of truly downtrodden, a very British girl who transcended nationality. Someone with a natural nobility who was classless and who proved in the last year that she needed no royal title to continue to generate her particular brand of magic. Today is our chance to say thank you. Thank you for the way you brightened our lives, even though God granted you but half of it. We will all feel cheated always that you were taken from us so young, and yet we must learn to be grateful that you came at all. Only now you are gone do we truly appreciate what we are without. And we want you to know that life without you is very, very difficult. We have all despaired for our loss over the past week, and only the strength of the message you gave us through your years of caring has afforded us the strength to move forward. There is a temptation to rush, to canonize your memory. There is no need to do so. You stand tall enough as a human being of unique qualities and do not need to see you as a saint. Indeed, to sanctify your memory would be to miss out on the very core of your being. Your wonderfully mischievous sense of humor with a laugh that when you double your joy of life transmitted wherever you took your smile and the sparkle in those forgettable, unforgettable eyes. But your greatest gift was your intuition, and it was a gift you used wisely. This is what underpinned all your other wonderful attributes. Without your God-given sensitivity, we would be immersed in greater ignorance at anguish of AIDS and HIV sufferers, the plight of the homeless, the isolation of the lepers, the random destruction done by the landmines. Diana explained to me once that it was her innermost feeling of suffering that made it possible for her to connect with her constituency of the rejected. For all the status, the glamour, the applause, Diana remained throughout a very insecure person at heart, almost childlike in a desire to do good for others, so she could release herself from the deep feeling of unworthiness. Diana, you taught us that life should have a meaning. It hardly matters how long it is. The world sensed this part of her character and cherished her vulnerability. The last time I saw Diana was on July 1st, her birthday. None. She was not taking time to celebrate a special day with her friends and relatives, but she was the guest of honor at a fundraising charity. Of course, she was sparkling with happiness for serving others. I would rather cherish the days I spent with her in March this year when she came to visit me and my children at her home in South Africa. I'm proud of the fact that apart from when she was on a public display meeting President Mandela.